Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. Or does it? Well, apparently according to a few brands and a few influencers, it does, and it's not filters. Apparently. Right, listen, I wasn't gonna make this video. I'm not feeling very well today. I'm hot, like I'm really warm. I feel a little bit lethargic. I started to walk my dogs, so I got this like red cap mark going on here. But I really wanted to film just a little chatty thing. I'm gonna do my skincare routine and we'll talk about this. But I wanted to talk about filters within, in particular, beauty advertising when it comes to skincare, makeup, the rules and new laws surrounding influencers using filters for paid promotion or to exaggerate the results or finish of a particular product. And I'm deciding to do it today because I'm kind of pissed off because Tarte Cosmetics just posted this video. I'm gonna play it now.
Hey, watch me shrink my pores instantly. Look at the results that you're seeing right here. This is not a filter, the primer. It's like a filter without a filter.
And this has pissed me off, not just because it's so poorly done, so bad, but for the fact that they clearly said there is no filter in this video when they're clear, like who the fuck do they think we are? How fucking stupid do they think we are that we cannot see this lady's skin jumping and glitching? Give us some fucking credit. But then I was looking at replies to the comment and some DMs that I got as well from people I know, and they were like, you know what, I know it sounds really stupid, but I actually would have thought this was the product if you didn't tell me that this was a filter. Usually when I do these Instagram versus reality videos, I always let you know that I am an editorial and advertising photography graduate and my learnings involved digital retouching and digital manipulation. So I guess I am kind of used to looking for these things. Listen, I'm not against digital retouching. I actually really, really enjoy it. I think if you creating a beautiful piece, like photography piece, I think it's great. What I am against is using filters to lie or to exaggerate and then lie about it. And I used to be very much against calling out brands or people who do this. When it's obvious, I think it's time to name and shame. One, because it's against the law now in certain countries, and because if we let this slide, this is gonna keep happening. Not everyone can spot a filter. And I do feel like I'm responsible for letting you know what brands are lying to you, basically. So let's name and shame whilst I do my skincare routine. So I've cleansed my face using Selfless by Hyrum Centella and Green Tea Cleanser. I'm just going to go in with a toner now because I like to do the rest of my routine on damp skin. This is the ELMT Frameless Centella Asiatica and Polysaccharide Advanced Calming Solution. I really, really like these on a Starface cotton pad. These just really do calm my skin. It's kind of red up there at the moment. So Norway are actually going to enforce a law. I'll read it from you here from the BBC. A new law in Norway is coming into force that will mean social media influencers can't post modified photos without declaring what they've done. The rules will affect any paid posts across all social media platforms as part of an effort to reduce body pressure among young people, which is great, which is so, so good. And this, as I always say, is where I have the issue, where really influencers are being paid to lie to you by using filters. Every single brand that I have worked with, I'm checking with my manager, but I'm going to show like a bit of the contract where it tells you you cannot use filters. Use as much natural lighting as possible or lighting that shows off the true texture and, you know, color of your skin. Absolutely no filters. So some of the examples I'm going to show you from a particular influencer, I feel I've been done post approval. Here's the process of a sponsored post. You get a brief from a brand. Well, they pitch to you, you're like, yeah or no. If you say yes, you get the brief, and then you have a certain time frame to finish the first draft. So they can see exactly what you're doing, showing, saying, using, etc. Then you make any changes, send them a second draft, and it's usually approved by then. However, what I feel some people are doing is applying a filter after the approval process, or some brands just don't care. We'll see. The Advertising Standards Association or something here in the UK also will fine influencers who are using filters to exaggerate the effects of a product. Hang on. There you go, that's better. One thing I did want to see with these filters and declaring filters was if anybody would notice. So recently on Instagram, I actually posted a picture that had like some fluffy skincare kind of chat, like, oh, I wish I had more than one face so I could try all these skincare products, and then said, you know what? How many of you actually read this description? How many of you flicking through your Instagram feed right now would realize how Photoshopped this picture is? And I provided a before and after. Some people were like, I wouldn't have noticed at all. The changes are so subtle. And others were like, I would have noticed this. And what I realize is the people that would have noticed the changes are people who are used to constantly posting online, talking about skincare, talking about makeup. And the people who didn't notice at all were people who had, you know, like lifestyle pictures, but everyday people who didn't work online or in social media, people who aren't exposed to these kind of pictures and filters, you know, every day of their life like we are. So I found that super interesting. So part of me was considering, and I asked, do you think just declaring that you're using a filter is enough in the description? Because, you know, we already put hashtag ad right at the bottom of our descriptions. For example, on Instagram, should there be a symbol on your picture? Should you have to watermark your symbol? Up at the top, should it say this picture has been photoshopped, or this picture has been filtered, or this picture has been altered in some way? What would be enough to make people see it that instantly? It's weird. I don't really know. I don't know. Let me know what you think. Should influencers be declaring that they're using a filter if it's not a paid advertisement? Because with paid advertisements and sponsorships, they shouldn't be using a filter. So for example, Tarte Cosmetics have broken several rules. I guess they're in the US, so I don't really know what the rules are there. It seems somewhat loose. If that was in the UK, no, you get a fine. I want to now, oh, what is this? The Dr. Sarah Call Vegan Kombucha Tea Essence. This is really nice. It's like a really thick, milky, moisturizing essence. Sorry, I'm not going to be talking much about the products. Let's take a look at Kylie Jenner's Instagram story, Kylie Skin. So please bear in mind that anything, because this is a brand's Instagram, anything that, I'm going to do another layer of this actually, anything that they're talking about when they're using their products is advertising their products, because it is their brand and they receive financial gain pretty much from any post, right? So, right, let's have a look at this. Let's watch this. This is too much.
So I just did some of my little hyaluronic acid serum. Now I'm gonna do my clarifying facial oil.
Like, come on. She looked like a Disney princess. The eyes were insane. The skin, there was no depth or definition to the face whatsoever. Why bother? Why you cannot do that? Listen, I get the pressures that a lot of influencers feel to look perfect on camera. You go natural, people are like, oh, you look like shit, put on some makeup, or you put on a filter and people are like, why are you so fake, you fake bitch? Do you know what I mean? Like, especially women within this industry cannot win. But when it comes to a brand, when it comes to the responsibility of showing real skin doesn't necessarily mean skin with blemishes or acne, it's just skin without a filter on it. You can't post something like that because that suggests that is what your products can do for someone's skin, make you look like fucking tangled what's her face. You just can't do it. And of course we expect nothing less from the Kardashians. Again, I've mentioned this before, but to me it's a bit of a difficult area because they are one of the most scrutinized families in the whole world for many, many different reasons. They probably get an onslaught of hate every single day, you know, so the pressure to look perfect is always there, perfect, but you can't. This is an advert from Curology that somebody added me in. That's a very heavy filter. That's an insanely heavy filter. She looks cute. And this is what makes me think this is an advert from Curology. Have they done this? Are they the ones that put that filter on the skin? You can't give fake results. It's just insane. It's harmful as well because people who are, she's definitely trolling. She's got amazing skin. She looks beautiful. I do think that's a bit of like a slidey filter on Facetune video, but that's a perfect example of lighting. I, for example, have two strip lights here. Can you see them? Like, look how different my skin looks. There, and then I have a soft box up here because I feel like you could see all the texture in my skin. I used to film with natural lighting and it was just too flattering, and I felt like as someone who talks about skincare, I have a responsibility to show my actual skin, but lighting can make a huge difference, which is what a lot of people said when I saw this video and posted about it, that oh, maybe it's just the lighting. It's not.
Morning guys, it is again before 9 a.m. Who am I? I don't know who I've become, but we're going filter this and it's before 9 a.m, which is two things that don't normally combine well for me. Glycolic fix pads. These pads are designed to exfoliate your skin and I love using these as an alternative to an actual exfoliator because...
How do I know that's filtered? Because her moles are disappearing. They're glitching in and out. She has a couple blemishes under her lip, which are blurring, and then at some points completely disappearing. This is a paid for advert from nip+fab here in the UK where you can get fined for using these filters on paid products when you are talking about a product when you are exaggerating the results of a product such as skincare. Now, I wasn't gonna necessarily say her name because I've learnt my lesson about kind of naming and shaming and getting it wrong. So not only has she done this for nip+fab, but she's used filters with Foreo and Elemis. In the past, when I didn't want to call out any names, she actually posted a heavily filtered video with the no filter filter on. And in this video, she actually said there is no filter, when we can clearly see the no filter filter. nip+fab then reposted it, cropping out the no filter filter part of the video. nip+fab are kind of known for allowing this. If you take a look through their Instagram profile, you can see so many, supposedly in my opinion, so many filtered videos, befores and afters. The CEO herself is also a fan of the filters, a huge fan of the filters. Look, I'm gonna go use a serum now. This is the COSRX Propolis Light Ampoule. My skin just needs that little bit of extra moisture recently and some calming and soothing and repairing. Could I have got this wrong? Maybe she just, her phone's a bit glitchy. Maybe her skin is just perfect and maybe her moles do disappear. But you know, I don't think so. And had it not been for that no filter filter, I wouldn't have said anything. If it hadn't been for the obvious disappearing moles, I wouldn't have said anything. Because I have been wrong in the past. I've been very wrong. Maybe last year, at the beginning of this year, maybe, no, it was last year, I called out Nicole Concilio for using filters on a before and after of a Fenty product. And she just posted her before and after of 17 days of using Fenty skin. I was sent this picture a lot and I went in. I was a fucking dick. Next, I'm going to use the Make Succulent Skin Gel Cream Serum Weight Moisturizer. I'm in love with this brand. I'm nearly out of this product. But basically that night, I was doing one of my Instagram versus reality videos. I was like prepping it and someone had sent me that and I was kind of pissed at this point, looking at all these other influencers using filters, and I posted on my stories, this shouldn't be allowed, look at her faking her results, all this kind of stuff. And she hadn't. I was wrong. I was completely wrong. Do you know what it was? It was probably a mix of like different lighting, but also Instagram really, really compressing the quality of the picture. This can often lead to areas being blurred for no particular reason and at no fault of the poster. And she was super sweet about it. We actually spoke in the DMs as well. And she pretty much just said, you know, had you have asked me, I would have just told you that I didn't and explained, you know? So this is the thing as well, is we can't go around pointing fingers, being like Photoshop, filtered, because Instagram doesn't really take kindly to high quality photos. So this is the issue. Where do we draw the line? When do we start calling people out? Should we be calling people out? I would say no. I would say don't go into people's pictures and start tagging me and be like, they're using a filter. I mean, tag me and don't say anything. But also there's so many things we have to take into consideration before instantly calling out a filter on someone. If they're known for using a no filter filter, if they look like a Disney princess, or if they claim there's no filter and your skin is literally glitching, then yeah, I think we're pretty safe to go ahead and say, that's wrong, you're using a filter. And if using filters is going to start becoming against the law when it comes to skincare makeup, we have to be careful who we're calling out because we may be mistaken, like I was. Oh, that was the Hello Sunday SPF 45, the one that's a serum. I used to really dislike these serum sunscreens, but I'm actually loving using the pipette as a method of measuring out how much sunscreen you need. So yeah, there we go. That's my little bit of a rant. It was probably everywhere. I'm sorry, because I'm a little bit lethargic, a little bit everywhere. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you think down below. Go ahead, edit your thumbnails, edit just nice pictures of yourself for fun. Disclose, you know, I edit some Instagram pictures and I always just say, you know, I've lightened my under eyes, I'm sat under studio lighting, or, you know, I've used a blue filter to knock out the reds in my skin. Just say, no one cares. People appreciate it more. Filters are just a part of life, I guess, and online now. I do think if you go into the extremes and changing your whole body shape, pretending it's you, blurring your skin, pretending that's you, I think it's wrong. Let me know in the comments down below. I'll leave my Instagram versus reality playlist here and some general light entertainment here. I'm gonna rest now. I'll see you over there.